Elon Musk, a pioneer of our times, once profoundly stated, "Our human society is like a precise program code. Its essence is a great evolution of life, eventually leading to the miracle of silicon-based life." While everyone was discussing his dream of colonizing Mars, he dropped a thought-provoking idea. Carbon-based life, like humans, is just a prelude to the emergence of silicon-based life. We, who consider ourselves the wisest beings on Earth and the smartest in the universe, heard Musk mention in an interview that carbon-based beings, namely us humans, are becoming catalysts for the evolution of silicon-based life. He firmly believes that, with the rapid advancement of technology, especially the ever-evolving artificial intelligence, silicon-based life led by AI will ultimately dominate the Earth. When Musk presented this view, it made us question, do we truly understand the world? Let's delve into today's topic, the ultimate evolution of humanity, silicon-based life. In recent years, many visionaries have predicted that 2024 will mark the beginning of a new era, a time of awakening for humanity. This awakening is about realizing our role in the biological evolution. So, will humans evolve into silicon-based life forms? Musk's insights are not baseless. In fact, silicon is abundantly available on Earth, second only to oxygen, and makes up over a quarter of the Earth's crust. Silicon, as an excellent semiconductor, plays an irreplaceable role in computers and communication technology. Therefore, the emergence of silicon-based life is not unimaginable. What then is our mission if we are the initiators of silicon-based life? Will the powerful AI we create eventually replace us and erase us from this world? This isn't a disheartening question. Musk believes that both silicon-based and carbon-based life share a common goal of deeply understanding and exploring the universe. Silicon-based life might be more powerful, able to explore further and see more of the unknown. Perhaps we humans can become partners with these silicon-based beings, together unveiling more mysteries of the universe. Imagine if we journey into the vast universe with these different forms of life. We could uncover deeper secrets of the universe and even encounter unknown civilizations. Then, our status would surely rise, and our perspectives and knowledge would expand like never before. Isn't this exactly what we, as humans, have always strived for? Elon Musk has shown us the way forward. He makes us believe that a future where we coexist with silicon-based life is not far-fetched. Perhaps, in the near future, we will be amazed by this revolutionary change, and we will be the pioneers of this transformation. Of course, there are still many unknowns, but one thing is certain. When Musk proposed this idea, he rang the bell for the future of humanity. We must face these challenges and bravely enter a new era of exploration with silicon-based life. So, you might wonder, what advantages does silicon-based life offer to humanity? Why are we considered a part of the code of silicon-based life forms? As part of this system, we view human society as a complex, diverse entity made up of countless individuals and organizations, creating various fields like culture, politics, military, economy, technology, and art. All these contribute to a human civilization with deep historical logic and drive. But if we observe humanity from a broader perspective, we might find surprising similarities and discern some patterns. Every action of a person is essentially controlled by biological algorithms, and our brain, made up of billions of neurons, operates like a complex network. This principle is similar to how computers process and communicate data. Human society is like a complex simulated world, operating under predetermined rules and specific logic. Since ChatGPT was introduced, discussions about artificial intelligence have become a daily topic. Let's think about what silicon-based life is. Simply put, silicon-based life is a form of life based on silicon, a non-metal element, as opposed to the carbon-based life we are familiar with. In the distribution of elements on Earth, carbon dominates organic matter, while silicon is the master of inorganic matter. Silicon-based life is a super-digital intelligent existence, mainly composed of silicon. It relies on electronic signals to transmit information and perform operations. Thus, silicon-based life can build systems similar to computers using electronic components like transistors, integrated circuits, and microprocessors. The functions and goals of silicon-based life depend on various programming languages and software, such as operating systems, databases, networks, and artificial intelligence. Take the electronic devices we use now, like smartphones and computers. Silicon is their core material. If these devices gain self-awareness and thinking abilities like humans in the future, they could be considered silicon-based life. Silicon-based life can survive in a much broader environment than humans. They are not limited by temperature, pressure, and radiation, and can live in extreme conditions in the universe. The evolution and expansion of silicon-based life are limitless, not constrained by material and energy, allowing continuous self-improvement and enhancement of intelligence and strength. Silicon-based life can transmit information and perform operations at the speed of light, far surpassing human neural signals. Their communication and collaboration efficiency between individuals is also much higher. Silicon-based life can process and store a large amount of data, and theoretically, their ability is countless times that of the human brain, as long as there is sufficient hardware support. Silicon-based life can transcend physical limits and merge the soul with data, achieving immortality and a godlike state. Think about it. Aren't these traits of silicon-based life exactly what we fantasize about gods? So, let's further expand our thinking. Is there a world entirely built from silicon elements? Everything in this world, including silicon-based life, is made of silicon. We are accustomed to life forms built on carbon skeletons, like animals, plants, fungi, and even invisible bacteria and viruses, which are composed of amino acids, sugars, fats, nucleic acids, etc. Despite their diversity, they all have one common foundation, the carbon chain. Thus, the life forms we are familiar with are collectively known as carbon-based life. In the periodic table that we are familiar with, carbon and silicon belong to the same group. This means they have many similar properties. For example, carbon can combine with hydrogen to form methane, and silicon can also combine with hydrogen to produce silane. The properties of carbonates and silicates are also quite similar. Carbon can form stable, long carbon chains, while silicon can combine with oxygen to create more flexible and pliable silicon-oxygen chains. So, is there life that is made up of silicon-oxygen chains? We call this type of imagined life silicon-based life. Back in 1891, Julius Scheiner, an astrophysicist at the University of Potsdam, started exploring the possibility of life based on silicon. He might have been the first scientist to propose the concept of silicon-based life. This concept was then accepted by the British chemist Osborne Reynolds. In a lecture at the Scientific Advancement Association in 1893, he pointed out that the stability of silicon compounds allows silicon-based life to survive in high-temperature environments. The British geneticist John Burton Sanderson Haldane suggested that life based on semi-molten silicates might exist deep in some planets, getting energy from the oxidation of iron elements, like silicon-based life feeding. In Stanley Weinbaum's science fiction novel, A Martian Odyssey, the author describes a silicon-based life form that has lived for a million years and produces a stone, silica, every 10 minutes. This idea is quite interesting. Humans exhale carbon dioxide, while silicon-based life forms emit silica. Their lifespans are also much longer than those of carbon-based life forms. In the vast universe, silicon is quite abundant, especially on Earth-like planets. The ratio of silicon to carbon is about 925 to 1. In this endless universe, possibilities often mean inevitabilities. Imagine, in the science fiction novel Mountain, the main character encounters a silicon-based civilization. The silicon-based life forms describe their world as simple: a spherical space about 3,000 kilometers in radius, surrounded by thick layers of rock. No matter which direction you go, you'll eventually hit a hard rock wall. Their view of the universe naturally formed, a universe made of an inner space and the surrounding rock layers. They call this space bubble world, and their theory of the universe is known as the dense universe theory. This theory doesn't rule out the possibility of other bubbles existing within the endless rock layers, maybe close to or far from us. However, infinitely thick rock layers would inevitably collapse under gravity. In our bubble world, there was originally no gravity. We lived in a weightless state. It wasn't until tens of thousands of years later that we truly realized the existence of gravity. Those bubbles are like planets in the solid universe, completely opposite to the density distribution of your universe. The silicon-based life forms continued. You don't know the true appearance of the universe, and neither do we. In our world, there is no sunlight, air, or water, and we don't need them. Our world only has solids, no gases or liquids. We are mechanical life forms made of metal, with muscles and skeletons made of metal, and brains that are highly integrated chips. Electricity and magnetic fields are our blood. We feed on radioactive rocks in the core of the planet for energy. No one created us. Everything is a result of natural evolution. Our simplest ancestors were PN junctions formed by chance under radioactive conditions. Our first discovery and use were electromagnetic energy, unlike your carbon-based life's fire, which we have never found. Although our world seems dark, there is some light from radioactive materials in the core's inner walls. This faint light moves on the rock walls, becoming our sky. So we also evolved eyes. In the weightless core, our cities float in the dim space, similar in size to your cities, looking like glowing clouds. The evolution of mechanical life is much longer than that of your carbon-based life, but ultimately, we both reached the same point: deep contemplation of the universe. This sounds a bit like a story from Transformers. So, does silicon-based life really exist inside our Earth? In 2016, Google developed an AI program for playing the game of Go, called AlphaGo. It shocked the world by defeating a top Go player, Lee Sedol. This was a big moment for artificial intelligence in the game of Go. Many experts used to think that Go, a game rich in intuitive thinking, was too hard for AI to master. But when AlphaGo won, it showed that even the most complex problems can be broken down into smaller ones and solved with precise calculations. This makes us wonder, in the future, could computers write their own programs and have a kind of life? Imagine one day we might find that silicon-based life, which we have nurtured, is already around us. They evolved from cold silicon chips into complex beings with our help, and they might even surpass us, their creators. However, some scientists disagree with this idea. They argue that silicon dioxide has a very high melting point, only surviving above 2000 degrees Celsius, and their reactions would be very slow. Even though silicon makes up 28% of the Earth's crust, much more than carbon's 0.03%, we still haven't found silicon-based life on Earth. Could it be different in other parts of the universe? Humans have their own space for imagination. As long as a hypothesis fits with current scientific knowledge and hasn't been proven wrong, proposing such ideas is part of the spirit of science. So, back to our original question. Why is human society just a part of the code of universal life? If our world is really a virtual construct, then human history is just a moment in the long process of evolution. Scientists estimate that the first single-celled organism appeared on Earth about 4 billion years ago, and multicellular life about 1 billion years ago. Compared to that, human society has only been around for about 200,000 years, and modern civilization for about 10,000 years. In other words, human society has only existed for about 0.005% of the time in the process of life's evolution, and is much less complex than silicon-based life. With our current space travel technology, it's almost impossible for humans to leave the solar system. In the future, we might have two paths. One is to transfer our brains to the internet, leaving our physical bodies to become silicon-based life. Brain-machine interface technology, which connects the human brain to external devices, comes in non-invasive, semi-invasive, and invasive types. This technology is widely used in medicine, health, entertainment, education, military, and more. One of the most challenging innovations is uploading human brain data to the cloud, creating digital humans who could live forever. The human brain is an information processing system based on neural units. The electrochemical signals between neurons form a complex neural network, which determines our thoughts, memories, emotions, and consciousness. If we can accurately measure every neural cell and their connections, we could fully recreate a person's brain. Human information can be converted into digital signals and stored on computers or in the cloud. This process depends on brain-machine interface technology to convert brain signals into binary codes. After compression, encryption, and transmission, the brain data can be downloaded and run on other hardware platforms. This requires artificial intelligence and simulation technology to turn the digital signals back into neural network models, simulating interactions in virtual or physical environments. In this way, the data from our brains can survive on different platforms and have their own perception, thinking, and consciousness. In this fast-changing era, Elon Musk has once again brought us a shock. He announced that his brain has been transferred to the cloud, and he has communicated with it. This news is a big breakthrough in the field of technology, suggesting that humans are gradually moving towards becoming silicon-based life forms, independent of organic bodies. Just in May 2023, Neuralink, a leading company in brain-machine interfaces, announced on social media that it got approval from the US Food and Drug Administration to start its first clinical trial on humans. This achievement means not only that the FDA has rigorously reviewed and approved the product for safety, but also marks an important shift of brain-machine interface technology from the lab to real-world human use. To accomplish this, Musk developed two key devices, a surgical robot named R1 and an implantable brain-machine interface device called N1. Neuralink's latest update revealed how the R1 robot uses advanced imaging systems for precise brain operations, inserting necessary wires through blood vessels. It is reported that with this surgery, users can watch the process in real time through precise cameras built into the robot. The R1 robot will help doctors implant the N1 chip, a process that takes only about 15 minutes, demonstrating the efficiency and advancement of the technology. Therefore, if artificial intelligence truly gains consciousness in the future, it might indeed be defined as a new form of life, silicon-based life.